Hey, what's up? This is Mikey at Blue Monkey Bicycles, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the Yamaha PWX Motor.
That's what I expected.
All right, so it should kind of go without saying, but here it is anyway. The motor disassembly for this particular motor was done by an electrical professional in a controlled environment. Even the external warranty work for an electric bike motor on a bike that you have is not user serviceable and should be done by a competent professional, such as the place that you got the bike from in the first place. Any kind of tampering with the motor will void the warranty. It very well could destroy the entire system, and you could even risk personal injury while doing it. So anyways, now that that's out of the way, let's actually get to it. If you didn't already know, Yamaha has been making electric bicycles for quite a long time overseas, but it wasn't until recently that they came into the US market. First, they were doing just electric systems, motors, batteries, displays, and they were letting other bike companies use the entire system to put on their bikes. As of this year, 2018, Yamaha is coming out with 4 electric bikes, all of their own, top to bottom, complete Yamaha bicycles. Right now they got 4, but who knows what they're gonna come out with in the future. There are a couple of clues.
Cool. Any plans for a dual suspension?
I love, what was that question again?
So yeah, tell me about the dual suspension bike.
So the dual, so the cross core over here.
Anyways, back to the motors. Up until now, we have been using the Yamaha PW motor, which is super awesome. I like it a lot. I've personally put a lot of miles on it, including a range test to find out how far it goes, up in the mountain trails, using it as a commuter. It's a really good system. But nonetheless, Yamaha was really anxious to get feedback from customers, from shops, from maybe even Ellen DeGeneres. I don't know exactly on that one, but wouldn't surprise me. Anyways, with the feedback from the PW motor, they did a lot of upgrades that wound up in the PWX motor and also the PWSE motor. I actually don't have one of those in hand, but anyways, there's lots of upgrades coming to both the SE and the PWX motor, and they include the following. A smaller, more durable display, which is a good move, Bluetooth connectivity, motor support up to 110 RPMs, anti-corrosion coating, a special one-way ventilation port that keeps the motor cool and protected from wet conditions, a one-way clutch design in the spindle, an auto-recalibrating torque sensor, that way the spring fatigue doesn't affect the motor engagement sensitivity, and many more software tweaks from their in-house motherboard programming. And from what I can gather on this particular bike of theirs, it looks like there is an internal wiring for the headlight and taillight. Let's get to the heart of the matter, which is the PWX motor. Now, it includes all those previous features and a lot more. As a standard, it is a 250-watt motor that is capable of 500-watt burst, rocking a 36-volt battery and goes up to a 20-mile-an-hour top speed, like most production mid-drives that you see on the market today. What makes it special is the little nuances that will add up into a very natural biking feeling, according to Yamaha. From a spec standpoint, the PWX is super dope anyways. The PWX packs a wallop with 80 newton meters of torque, a maximum assist output of 320%, and it keeps going up to 120 RPMs. The display mounted on the side of the stem is tucked away out of trouble, and you can decide where the perfect place is, as it can be installed on the left, the right, behind, or in front of the handlebars. The PWX system has 5 levels of pedal assist: Eco Plus, Eco, STD, High, and EXPW. And that one goes up to 320% output, by the way. And you can get Yamaha Power Assist bicycles by shopping at bluemonkeybicycles.com, including the YDX Torque model, which has the PWX system. More information coming soon as to the particulars, but yeah, don't forget that we have bikes on our website. Anyways, moving on. Okay, mechanical spec time. The spindle length is 135 millimeters and the motor itself weighs in at 3.1 kilograms. The PWX is lighter than some of its competition, and the physical dimensions are 220 millimeters long, 155 millimeters tall, and 80 millimeters wide, not including the spindle on that one. It also has a faster ratcheting pedal engagement, machined holes on some of the alloy gears, and composite gears to decrease weight and keep durability. The swing out battery mounts on the down tube and has an integrated lock into the frame instead of the battery. It's kind of a small detail, but it is kind of nice in case you have a second battery or you want to switch batteries. You don't have to worry about getting a different key for a different battery. You just got one key for the bike and then that's it. Also, there are two battery pack sizes from Yamaha. There is the 400 watt hour pack and the 500 watt hour pack. As to which one you get with which bike, it really just depends. But more often than not, if you get a really cool bike with a really cool system, you're probably gonna have the really cool, larger 500 watt hour battery pack. So yeah, be aware of that. Now we're getting a little deep here, but not all of the Yamaha systems, even the PWX, are going to have the same features and feel the same way on different bicycles from different bicycle companies. Now the reason for that is that bicycle company A, let's say, might have the Eco Plus setting set for, I don't know, like 70% output, whereas bicycle company B, using that same Yamaha system, might have Eco Plus set for like 80% output. So even those two bikes using the two systems could have it customized a little bit differently to fit the rest of the electric bike lineup or to make a mission-specific bike or something like that. For example, I have ridden dozens of different electric bikes with the Yamaha PW system, and each time it feels a little bit different, but it's a great performer in its class. One of my favorite bicycles with that system is the Easy Motion Rebel 27.5 Lite. Now that bike is a lot of fun on the road, but off-road it really shines. It's got great balance, it gets up to speed really quickly, and yeah, that bike is very nimble, lots and lots of fun. I can't wait for the PWX version to come out because that's going to be dope. Big thanks to Yamaha Power Assist Bicycles for providing the PWX motor that we used to illustrate in this video. I'll actually be testing the PWX motor in the very near future. And at that time, I'll be able to give you my report on how it feels and any other features that I'm able to notice once I actually get rubber to the road and see what it feels like. In an upcoming video segment, we'll be comparing the PWX to a bunch of other motors in its class, such as the Shimano E8000, the Broza S, and a head-to-head rematch between the Yamaha PWX and the Bosch CX motor. So stay tuned to that, to the channel, because lots of fun stuff is coming up.